there are heaps of glute burnouts that you can use. Choose one that you prefer, enjoy, and you get a great glute pump from. With all the burnouts, make sure you maintain tension out against the band during the burnout and don't let your knees fall in like that and let the band lose tension. The first burnout that I like to use is called the ladder. So we lie on our back into a glute bridge position. We find the optimal glute bridge position. And then from there, we're doing 10 glute bridges reasonably quickly while we're ripping the band apart. Once we've done 10, then we do 10 abductions, ripping the band apart, making sure you're not letting your knees drop too far in. From there, you go to 9 bridges, 9 abductions, 8 bridges, 8 abductions, all the way down to 1. If that gets too easy, start at 12 and go all the way down to 1. If that gets too easy, go from 15 all the way down to 1. The next burnout's called a Crabbie. So we're going 50 lateral banded walks, so 25 each leg, ripping the band apart, making sure that we're not bringing the other leg back in too far to lose the tension on the band. So we're going 50, 25 each leg. From there, we're getting into a seated hip abduction. We're going 10 leaning back, maintaining the tension on the band, 10 in at 90 degrees with your hip, then 10 leaning forwards. If that gets too easy, go to more, so 12 or 15 of each position, or choose the position you feel it most in your bottom. Some people feel it more here, or leaning forwards, whatever suits you. In terms of technique, what we're doing is we're ripping out and we're rolling to the outside of our feet as we're doing it. As I was saying before, don't let the tension get released. So keep the tension out against the band during the reps. The next burnout's called a cha-cha. So we're going 50 lateral banded walks, 25 each leg, ripping the band apart. Then we're grabbing a pole, a bench, and getting our body down into a nice horizontal position with the ground. And then we're ripping one leg on a 45 degree angle out to the side, keeping the tension on the band. So we're ripping slightly out to the side like that. Again, we're not coming too far in to lose tension on the band. We're ripping as far as possible, maintaining tension. We're going 20 each leg. Then from there, we're going into your seated hip abductions again. We're going 10, 10, 10, or choose the position you feel it most in your glutes and go for roughly 30. As I've said before, you can do more if it starts to get easy. This is the frog pump burnout. What we want to do is high rep frog pumps, close to fatigue, and then from there we're going to do an abduction movement with the band around our knees. So the frog pump position is like that, heels towards your bottom as far as possible, let your legs splay out to the side, elbows into the ground. From there you can have your head resting like this, so you're looking straight up, or chin tuck like that, and then you're pumping out reps quickly, big butt squeeze at the top. You can add a band around your knees for that, so you're pulling out against the band. You can also add a dumbbell across your hips so you don't have to do as many reps. We're looking at high reps, so roughly 50 or more. Then from there, we're going into abductions. So there's a few options. We could do bridge abductions like this, going high rep bridge abductions. So we're looking at say 20 to 30 there, or we're going into a lateral banded walk, looking about 50, 25 each leg, or we could go into a seated hip abduction, leaning back, neutral, or leaning forwards, or choose a position that's really hard, one of the three, and doing roughly 30 there. Another way to finish the frog pump burnout after you've done the frog pumps is to do an extra range side-lying hip abduction, which is on a bench with the bottom knee bent like that. So you're right off the edge of the bench. Then from there, let the top leg hang down over the edge of the bench. Have your toes pointed downwards. So big toe pointing into the ground. Then from there, you're coming up, squeezing your glute at the top. We're going high rep here. We're looking at 20 to 30 reps or even more. You can also add an ankle weight around your legs. Now, you can use that at the end of any other burnout if you want to replace something else. The only problem with it is you're going to have to do both sides. So it is a little bit more time consuming. So there's another option with a glute burnout finisher. Here's another burnout, the reverse hyper burnout. You can do this where you get the bench and elevate it onto a box so you can drop your legs further down towards the ground to get a little bit more of a stretch on the glutes. But we're hanging off the edge like this. Then from there, we're ripping the band apart and then we're coming up into a reverse hyper like that. We're doing 10 to 20 there, maintaining the tension out against the band. So you're ripping the band apart. Then get into a frog pump position like that. So you're ripping the band apart. And then from there, you're doing the same thing, coming up, squeezing your bottom at the top. Again, we're looking for high reps. So 20 to 30 there, and then jump up and you can get into your lateral band of walks, 50 there. Or you could do seated hip abductions, extra range, side-lying hip abductions. You could do bridge abductions, anything that's gonna get a big glute burn at the end of that set. This is the last glute burnout option that I use. It's a hip thrust burnout. So we're ripping the band apart, getting into a hip thrust position. From there, keeping your chin tucked. Then we're going high reps. So you could do anything from say 20 to 50 reps here. Then we go into abductions. So the bottom here, we do abductions. So we're looking for high rep here. So 10 to 30. And then from there, come up into the hip thrust position and performing abductions up there and then come back down. One thing to note about your lateral band of walks, you can perform them more upright like that or into more of a squat. Do it in whatever position you feel the most in your glutes. Another option you do have with any glute burnout is you can replace any part of a glute burnout with a side-lying hip raise. So we start with our knees together like that, heels together, hips back a little bit, elbow on your hip, elbow underneath your shoulder, then from there you're driving up and then bringing that top knee up while you drive your hips forward. This you can do to high reps. So we're looking at say 10 to 30 reps each side. The other way you can do it is you can bring the whole leg up like that and bring the feet off each other. So side on, it'll look a little bit more like this. So drop those hips back, drive those hips forward, big squeeze at the top, and drive the top knee up or the whole leg up like that.